On your word.
Hmm.
You guys could wake the dead. Oh! I skipped that. Alright, well, you guys can go back and pause the video. I missed that. More interruptions. The woman sets down the book she holds, smiling faintly. What an interesting time we've been having of late. So many uninvited guests. I suppose I have you to thank for all the damage to my work. It took time to get those people back on their feet, you know. Osyra frowns. What is it you're doing here? We're gonna fight and die now, aren't we? Were those yours? I prefer cats myself. Perception 12. Well, we might trick her by doing this. Lord Radric sent me to check on your progress. Osyra regards you coldly for a moment. At last, she throws her arms up in the air in frustration. Of course he did. I thought I'd have a few days, at least, before he resumed his growling. If Lord Radric wishes to see swifter progress, then perhaps he might deign to provide the materials I need. Does he think he is the only one growing impatient? I am gifted with this, she gestures to the room, pitiful little laboratory, and he expects miracles. And meanwhile, that old wretch, that useless priest, has the whole of the upper keep to himself. What does he provide? Superstition and useless advice. She lets out an angry gust of air. Very well, then. Look upon my progress. I have made what use of Kolsch's filthy cohorts I was able. Tell Radric that I will have more useful information for him once I have been given adequate time for study, she snorts. If you're lucky, he won't hang you in my place. Probably end up fighting them if you click on them, right? I don't want to fight them, I just want to see if... I don't think there's any dialogue things, I just want to see what happens. We can't do anything, we just kind of gather around them. What the hell's that? Ooh, it's a black cat! We can talk to it, apparently. Hell with you, I'm talking to the cat. At first you think this poor creature is diseased, for its black fur seems to have fallen off its hide in patches. But when the cat turns to investigate a fly on the wall, you note that an entire section of its rib cage is open to the air. Some of its tail is rotted away, altogether to reveal a few jagged vertebrae. Oh, poor kitty. This doesn't seem to bother the cat much. It lets out a trilling purr and rubs against your shin. Kicking the cat would be mean and would probably be attacked for that. Pet the cat? You spend a few pleasant moments scratching the cat between the ears. Black fur comes away in clumps. In real life, guys, I would never do this. Pick up the cat. I wouldn't even pet it because it's falling apart. It's pretty disgusting. You'll probably pick it up and all its innards will fall out. You pick up the surprisingly light and unexpectedly pointy creature, and it purrs contentedly in your arms. Ha ha! We've gained an item, Black. We have it. We have this item. Well, if you want to call it an item, it's a pet. This small black cat makes a grisly companion, for its thin hide is stretched over its bones. The skin is rotting away. Around its chin, and there is an unsavory gleam in its golden eyes. All the same, it seems content to twine about your ankles, purring. That's hilarious. Is it on the ground following us? No, it's just in our inventory. Not like the cosmic, whatever that thing is. We have it still, don't we? Giant miniature space piglet. Do move along. Radric's a demanding fellow, and I have much to do. No one mind the priest.
I'll see what I can find.
Now, who sees him? If she sees him, we'll be attacked. If only the undead see him, we might be fine. A fine stiletto, hunting bow, 225 copper skeets. No. Okay. Sorry guys, that's a problem with my mic. When I move it, it does that. And actually, I didn't move it, that was my head moving up because I was trying to drink something. So yeah, I'm going to be getting a hold of Sennheiser. So they're all going to attack now, so we might as well switch back to melee. We might die now. Amplified thrust off of who's near. Firebrand? Off of Firebrand. Where is he? Okay. I gotta attack this Osyra then. Where is she? Here? Is this her? This is her. So she should move away from this ghoul, rather attack it. Eat her. Alos. Theodas. Well, Eater's all the way over here. Knockdown. See if we can get through to her. Can't even use that because technically we're not in combat. So we'll just wait a sec. And Kenna. Is this him? That's Theodos. Oh, this is Kenna here? I thought this was an undead. Okay. Well, obviously you're attacking her. Oops, sorry about that, guys. Alright, now we can cast this. And it's gonna get us all, apparently. Eh? Oh boy. Oy, yay. I'm gonna die now. We still have yet to cast this spell. You know what, Theodas? Mind blades on this thing. Is this fast? Average? We'll see if it works, because she's got something on her, so. Who's this? Yeah, Theodas. Still has yet to cast his Holy Radiance.
Yes.
Alright, some healing. Fortunately, it was spread out a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Did she knock down? I guess she did. Not sure. I can't see. No. Knock down him now. This isn't working. Oh, did we get her? Eater killed her. Oh, sweet. Awesome. We're gonna be okay. You three, get him. Magic missile.
This isn't working!
Jibs! It's working. Oh, we got one more. I forgot about him. Everybody pile on this last ghoul. Hello! How dare you not let us steal from you? Osyra's Grimoire. Let's give it to Aloth. A rod. Spirits. 227 copper pans. And a key. Rusted iron cell key. Maybe to let that guy out.
What?
I said to maybe let that guy out. Alright, might as well get the rest of the crap. A fine stiletto. Isn't our very own Firebrand using a stiletto? She's using a saber. Who is using a stiletto? Anybody? Well, hold on a second. Well, she's using an axe. Oidrecht. Fine S-stock. Okay, we'll just put that away. I guess this is going to be a two-part episode, because we're already 43 or so minutes in. Excuse me. Got a lot of grimoires now. Osyra. Okay, she's got Alchemir's... Oh wait, no, that's his spells that he knows, right? She's got Minoletta's Minor Missiles, Jolting Touch, Fleet Feet, Council Hort's Corrosive Siphon, Binding Web, Fireball, and Crackling Bolt. Lots of goodies. We've been in there. And more to explore. Because we got... Oh no, that's... We've been in there. But... Oh, I guess that's it. We do have to let that prisoner out. I wonder if he'll want to join us. I mean, we have no room in our party right now. Let's sneak.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
So make sure this isn't trapped. Okay. Admith Hadret, Part 2, Rebellion. 124 copper skeets. Sorry about that, guys. Oh, we have two of them. We're looking for one. I don't think we have Part 1. Okay, we've got a lot of copies of this. That was weird. Okay. The Deerwood Part 6. Still looking for 3. Alright, I guess that's that. Well, she did. Like her followers. I wonder if that key... I stopped, I thought it was alive. Or animated, you know. Unlock with rusted iron cell key. Hello? Giacco. Oh, this was the guy we was talking about. The, what's his name upstairs was talking about him. Right, and if we helped Giacco, he was going to help us. This young man's face is badly bruised, and his gaunt form is covered in a threadbare shirt. He watches you, shivering, with a measure of hope in his eyes. I don't know who you are, but will you help me? Kenna says, poor lad's taking a beating. We're trespassing as it is. Let's set him free and take a single scolding for it. Giacco gazes nervously past you at the open cell door. I don't think I can fight my way out. I'd like to choose three, but I'm not sure if we can go back and choose two after. I really want to choose three and then two, but sometimes we can't go back. So I'm just going to say, you must be Giacco. Nedmar sent me to find you. Nedmar? Giacco gives a quiet laugh of disbelief. The priest sent you? I thought he'd leave me here to rot. He wasn't too happy when I left the keep. I told him I could do far more good with Kulsh than as an acolyte. He accused me of joining a band of outlaws. Looks down at his feet. I guess we were both wrong. I take it you ended up here after assaulting the keep with Kulsh and his men. Get to say it after all. Yes, he looks away. It seemed a good plan. We got in without incident, and I knew the way. But we were surprised in the dungeons. And most of us? He shudders. You have seen some of them. Fought them. Their bodies, at least. Not their minds anymore. But their souls. The woman down here. Radric's animancer. Her name is Osyra. Correction, her name was Osyra. I've heard her speaking sometimes, talking about a cure. Lord Radric calls on her often. But she's not curing anyone. She's only turned men and women into monsters. He shudders. I watched her take the others. I was sure I'd be next. Well, I'm glad we, killed them and got the key. Alos shakes his head. Men and women turn to this evil to cure Hollowborn? Madness. What can you tell me about Nedmar? Nedmar has been a father to me, really. My actual father was a traitor. That's traitor, guys, not traitor. And he died in a bandit raid when I was young. I don't remember him much. I remember the days after, though. Stuck here in Gilded Vale, begging for food. Nedmar was a priest of the Scattered God back then. He took me in and raised me in the church. I was going to follow in his footsteps, even after he converted, and we turned to the twinned god. But I started seeing what was happening to Gilded Vale, what Radric was doing, and Nedmar, he just kept on saying that things would work out. That we had to stand by the Lord of the Keep. Kulsk was the only one who seemed willing to do anything about it, instead of, well, preaching. He smiles sadly. So that's two fathers I've left behind. Tell me about Osyra. There's something not right about her. A bad feeling, I mean. I knew the moment she arrived, things would take a turn for the worst. He shivers. There's nothing good comes of dealing with animancers. Unnatural, the lot of them. She's the one who transformed them, changed my friends into monsters, said she was doing it for the good of Gilded Vale. Giacco clenches a fist, more like the good of her coin purse and her sick curiosity. She's dangerous, and who knows what else she's got in her laboratory. I wouldn't go in there. She has a convincing manner. Spells, no doubt. Well, we've been in there already, and she's dead. Giacco breathes in sharply, surprised, before sagging with relief. Good. She deserved far worse. Maybe with her gone, the people she's changed can pass on to the next life. I hope so, anyway. Brave of you to take her on, those animancers. You never know what they're capable of. You're free. Make a run for it. Thank you, stranger. I have to get back to the fork. Magwin's fork? But first, some food and rest, I think. Tell Nedmar... Well, tell him I still have the carving of the pale knight he gave me as a boy, and that I hope he is well. Good luck, and may the gods keep you safe. And he walked out of our life. Awesome. We'll set him free. Is there anything to look at in here? No. Well, apparently we finished in here. We can go back upstairs and not fight Radric some more so he won't die, and head back to Nedmar. I know, guys. We have to go back to Cadnua and investigate that shimmering door. I forgot all about it. To return. We've accomplished a lot, so let's save. And we're actually in episode 52 now, anyway. Aren't there traps here, or did we set them all off already? We're done with the dungeon. Is there more that way? Hold up.
Shh.
Oh, no. Okay. Let me just check the wall. Alright. Yummy drink. Alright, so. Is he on this floor? I can't remember. Or is he up here? I think he's up top, Nedmar. I believe he's up in here. Surprised they don't mark him on the map. Maybe he'll reward us with some camping supplies. Sorry guys if I'm getting a little repetitive about the camping supplies, but this way we don't have to walk all the way back to town. Is he in here? Or... where is he? Or in there? Can we even get in there? Hold on. Where the hell is this guy? Where's my quest marker? Someone came back over here. Nedmar? Nedmar. Hi, Nedmar. You've returned. Have you found him? Are there any survivors? We can rest here? Giacco is safe. He asked me to tell you that he's kept the carving you gave him as a boy. Nedmar's eyes widen. With sudden vigor, he rushes forward to grasp your arm. Oh, thank the gods. Thank you. I did not think you could... That is, I feared... He shakes his head. I did not want him to meet the Pale Knight so soon. Nedmar pulls away, collecting himself. Here, what I promised you in return. He pulls a large iron key from the pocket of his robe and hands it to you. This will open a door in the scriptorium. He points west. Awesome. And from there you can reach the chapel and Lord Radric without encountering quite so many guards. We're done with that guy. We already found him the hard way. It's fine, though. We needed the experience. Take this, too. I have little wealth to offer. Better to give something of use. I would entreat you before you go. Despite his shortcomings, Lord Radric follows the gods with obedience, and he has Gilded Vale's best interests in mind. It may be that with time he can achieve what he desires. Please consider this before you turn to violence. What does this key open? It is a master key. Nedmar wrings his hands as he speaks. It will not open every door, but it will permit you access to the stairs leading down into the Lord's Chapel. It will also open the doors along the keep's main hall, but you will face heavy fighting if you go that way. Been there, done that, guy. You do not have much time. Whatever your intent, Lord Radric will soon discover that one of his prisoners has escaped, and then you will lose the element of surprise. I thought you'd favor Kolsch as Lord of Radric's Hold. I favor him as he is, a man of vision, but Kolsch has a hunger in him for rule, even if to good purpose. He is not led by his faith. Still, he is my friend, and I am willing to assist Kolsch in restoring divine favor to the lands of Gilded Vale, should Lord Radric fall, that is. I need to rest. Of course, I'll bar the door. Yes! Hooray!